Hello, I'm Dr. Robert Zieber at Luz Medical Aesthetics. We're here today to talk about laser hair removal. Here at Luz Medical Aesthetics, we use the SPLENDOR X from Lumenis. And the way it works, it's the melanin, the pigment in the hair, that absorbs the energy from the laser and heats up. And in an actively growing hair, it's possible that heat can kill the root, in which case the hair does not come back. Sometimes though, it'll just injure the root, in which case the hair can grow back, but it'll be thinner and lighter at that point. So we do the treatments as a series because not all the hair is actively growing at one time. And assuming you're average, you can expect about 60% of the hair to be gone with 6 treatments, and the other 40% should be thinner and lighter at that point. So assuming you're average, if you want all the hair to be gone, it's more like 12 treatments on the body. Now the face is an exception. The facial hair tends to be more stubborn than hair elsewhere on the body, and especially so for those clients with hormonal issues like polycystic ovaries. But even for those clients, one thing that happens, as you get more treatments into it, the time it takes for the hair to start growing again gets longer. And at least initially, we'll start off with appointments for body hair at every 4 weeks and facial hair every 2 weeks. But as you get more treatments into it, we will space that out farther so that we're treating actively growing hair. Now, for those clients with facial hair and hormonal issues, sometimes they require maintenance every 2 to 3 months to keep the hair down. And that may be a bit of a hassle, but at least it's better than shaving every day. In preparation for your laser hair removal treatment, you want to shave the area that we'll be treating. The laser only needs that very little bit of hair that's inside the skin to work, which is part of the reason why laser hair removal is ideal for ingrown hairs and probably the best treatment for them. But you want to shave the area, because the hair that lays on top of the skin, it will absorb the energy from the laser too and heat up, and that makes it hurt much more. On the subject of pain, the laser does feel like a hot rubber band snap. That's the best description, I think. But each pulse of the laser, we treat an area that's about a square inch. So for example, for underarms, it's 20, maybe 30 pulses on each side. It actually goes pretty quickly. It takes just a couple minutes to do underarms. Now the only time we've run into issues with the laser, one is with makeup. Some makeups can absorb the energy from the laser, heat up, and burn the skin. So it's best to come in with clean skin. And this holds true for other parts of the body too, particularly the underarms. You want to come in without deodorant, because some deodorants can reflect the light, and that's counterproductive. The other precaution we need to take with the laser is the laser makes your skin more sensitive to the sun. And we recommend no significant sunshine to the area we're treating for at least 4 days after each treatment. Now that's not to say you can't walk to your car, but you wouldn't want to go to the beach or sit poolside. And if you have been out and your skin's darker or tanner than normal, it's best to wait at least 2 weeks before getting another treatment. Also, let us know because we can change the settings on the laser to make it safer. After your laser hair removal treatment, the skin may be a little flushed. You might also have just small areas of swelling right around the hair follicles themselves. This is normal and usually goes away within an hour. The skin itself is not harmed or injured during laser hair removal treatment. However, you need to avoid significant sun to the area. This can cause pigment changes, dark spots, light spots to the skin. We recommend no significant sun to the treatment area. Now, when you come in, you'll get to meet with me to answer any other questions you might have. We'll review your medications and allergies. There are some medications that make the skin more sensitive to the laser. And if you are taking regularly a medication that's on this list, we will do test spots on your first visit and then have you return in 2 weeks to evaluate whether there's been any pigment changes to the skin. If there hasn't, then at that point we can commence with treating. So if you have any further questions or if you'd like to learn more about laser hair removal, please give us a call at 951-694-3600 or schedule an appointment and come in. I'm looking forward to seeing you.